Hello, my name is Sausage, and welcome back to my playthrough of Xenoblade Chronicles. Last we left off, we were still getting the prospector ponds, or pond specters, there you go. And that is mostly what we have been doing. We haven't done a whole lot of main story. Because it gives us the ability to go pick up all these guys on the way. And that is a lot more fun. Okay, so I feel like I can go almost everywhere now. I may start going for some of these red exclamation marks. Of course he wants me to go somewhere else. Okay, literally, that's funny. I was just about to go over to these. There's no other quests on the map, right? Well, I haven't been anywhere down here. Oh, I didn't even see this guy over here. Despite what the map is saying, I feel like I'm right. Worst case, if I'm too high, I can drop down. So I want this guy while I'm over here. I have 10 of 20. Okay, is there another one of those? I guess it's further down.
Feeling wonder marvelicious.
Stay strong.
Okay, guess we'll try this. Please don't push me out. Never get that last. To fight that thing. What is that? Are there enough guys here? That's pretty irritating. This guy shouldn't have been able to kill me. Thank you. Okay. Is this another secret area back here? No. So I still can't get into whatever this is. I thought this would put me on top of that thing. Oh yeah, there was one over here. There was an enemy blocking it. I still think I can do this.
Yeah.
This is the last one again. And I cannot hit that. Is this gonna be literally the first lead that we have taken out? Really jump. All right. I think I have the entire blue team now. So forget the main quest. At least I think. I don't know if I can get through this gate or not. Apparently not. Really?
Nay, nay, not feeling wonder marvelicious.
That was not very wonder marvelicious, I agree. Oh man.
Nay, nay, not feeling wonder marvelicious. Not to worry.
This can't be that hard.
Improvising.
Apparently it is.
Nay,
I was trying to go from there and jump across, but maybe I'll try to jump straight up on it again. I think I was way overthinking that.
Not to worry, he no good at improvising. Why would all those Telethia be gathering here in one place?
Transporter, over here!
Huh?
What is it?
The transporter is running.
So it is.
But how?
Maybe somebody activated it.
In any case, we can't afford to dally here.
Agreed. Let's go.
I'm positive I can't go through here yet. I'm pretty sure I can't. I don't think it'd be that. Quick. So it looks like Alchemoth. And there's another dude here.
Good to be back.
Home of Miss Melly needs some weeding.
Housekeeping been slacking off.
Very true. We'll have our work cut out for us.
What is it?
Look up there.
What is that thing?
Look like hole in sky.
That's simply impossible.
This world is still in its early days. That could explain the instability. That, or it's still being reborn.
Does that really explain this?
It could do.
That Fog King creature. Is it from...
It's a possibility.
In that case, it may well be lurking nearby. Let's stay together and keep a close lookout.
King of Fog, not scary to Kino.
Kino, how about turn around and toe to face?
Bye-bye-bye!
Gotcha! Little joke there.
No, big meanie!
Mama?
A child's voice. Where?
Up there!
Okay, so we have to go up here anyway.
Are you all right, child? Wait, Teelan.
Ah, Miss Melia. You too, Shulk? How did you...
We can talk later.
I don't know what song this is, but it's a bop.
We can only hope. Look! The rift!
It's... Oh no! Look out!
Ha!
That beam...
What about it, Shulk?
That was the same attack that brought down the junks.
Then that would mean...
It looks like we found our Fog King.
Yes, I would have to agree. What now, Shulk?
We might as well try. Nene!
Understand!
It won't work! You can't even land a scratch on it!
Mama!
Melia! Kino!
Leave to me! Eat face full of pain!
Be gone!
King of Fog, bright dust!
It is just as Maxis said then.
Melia! Let's pull back!
That would seem wise.
Okay, this should be far enough. Those things can't follow us all the way out here.
Oh? And you're certain of that?
Yeah, sure. The Telethia will keep us safe.
The Telethia will?
Well, that's what Radsom said. Though, I don't think they realize it themselves.
Ah. Right. Your mother was one of the affected.
Yeah. Oh, I haven't thanked you yet. Thanks a million for saving me back there.
Why were you alone in such a place? You could have been hurt.
Sorry, miss.
He get told? Pipe down, not on obvious.
I snuck in to gather research material. But then, I tripped over some rubble and...
And that's when you were spotted, huh? Were you the one who activated the transporter?
Yeah. I was given special permission, so I could conduct my research. That said, I normally don't go anywhere without Big Sis.
You have a sister?
Well, we're not actually related. We've just been living here together.
If I remember correctly, you wanted to transform Telethia back?
Yeah. Oh, hey! My lab's over on the far end of Zen's thoroughfare. You want to come with? We can talk more there, where it's safe.
You have your own laboratory.
Not as grand as my old one, mind.
We still don't understand the Fog King, or the monster that attacked Teelan. Maybe the Telethia are connected to all this. Teelan's research could help us make sense of it all.
Yes, indeed.
The thing that attacked... Oh, you mean the Fog Beast?
Fog Beast? Is that what you've been calling them around here?
Fog Beasts always appear around the Fog King, so the name seemed appropriate.
Makes sense.
Right, I'll be going on ahead.
You won't be guiding us on the way.
I need to clean up, else there won't be anywhere to stand. All right, see you.
Hey, wait!
He's gone now.
Okay, can I go back to Alchemoth and get that one dude?
What is it about science boffins? Always doing whatever they please.
Huh?
He get told. He probably have it coming.
Thrice damned fools.
They think to second guess the will of the divine.
Never would have guessed he was evil. Ooh, Earth Shop. Okay, that's his shop. I guess it was on the ground floor, it wasn't on the upper floor. Forced to fight at least one of these. Thank you.
How many times have I told you, you do not go there alone?
But I really needed that material.
Doesn't matter. Why did you disobey me?
Oh.
If something happened to you, we would lose everything.
Amelia's sister.
Tyrea?
Melia?
Huh? Wait a second. You know Melia, big sis?
Tyrea's your big sis.
Right. That explains how you came to the capital just in time to save Teelan's skin.
Sorry.
Sorry for the trouble. Truly. Although I am glad you were there.
Yeah, you really helped me out, Shulk, Miss Melia. And you too, Kino, Nene.
Tyrea, I didn't expect to see you here, helping Teelan with his research.
Yes, well.
Tyrea, she's changed.
Teelan, I'm going outside for a bit to get some air.
Got it. I didn't know you all knew Big Sis Tyrea. How'd you meet each other?
Well, that's because Tyrea and I share an older brother.
Huh? Does that mean you and her are sisters then?
Sisters? No. It's rather more complicated. But sisters, we are not.
Hmm. Well, still, that means you know her from way back. What was she like?
Hmm?
I've only known her here, in this place, so I gotta wonder how she was before.
She was... She was strong, both in body and in her conviction for doing what she thought was right.
Wow! Pretty much the same as how she is now, then. When it comes to our research, she's even more committed than I am.
So she has not forgotten her mother.
Where did you and Tyrea meet?
It was when she saved me from the Fog King.
On a trip to Alkemoth, like today.
What? No. At the time, everyone was still living there.
Before the Fog King showed up?
Yeah, and then, after we all escaped, I was kind of on my own, so Tyrea brought me here for safety.
One moment. Teelan, was your father not still around?
My father was killed by the Fog King.
Is that so? I'm sorry.
Teelan just like Kino. Brave little pun.
I think I'll get some air too.
Go ahead. I've still got things to ask Teelan, so I'll stay with him.
Good, thank you. Shan't be long.
Miss Melly, Kino go too.
Kino, please read room.
Tyrea.
Of all the people to meet out here.
How did you?
Pure chance. After everything, I wandered aimlessly looking for somewhere to die. Then, at some point, I landed here.
So then, you were here all along?
That's right. And so, when the capital fell here, I thought Mother had finally granted me my boon.
But it was full of Telethia. And survivors cast adrift. Not to mention this Fog King.
Yes. He'd be the one to end it. or so I thought. Until fate had me save Teelan, and death ceased to be an option.
Your mother, she did not grant you a dying place. She gave you our future by crossing your path with Teelan's.
My helping with Teelan's research is a simple matter of give and take.
If you really believed that, you would not have treated him half so warmly. I can tell that when you look at Teelan, you see family. Even if it was once transactional, his research concerns the future of our race. That fact remains.
The future of the High Entia, huh? And what about you?
Me?
You must have heard. Our brethren in this land are suffering.
Yes.
You are the Imperial successor. The Crown Princess, war or no war. No. Empress now. What will you do about the future of our race?
I have not planned that far ahead. However, I know enough to realize what I must do right now.
I hope to see it. This future you will build for us. And when I do, I hope I'll be able to accept what I now am.
Empress Melia, so you are ready to lead us after all. It shall be my privilege to clear the stones from your path.
Creepy stalker dude.
Did you learn anything from Teelan?
A little. He said that for all the details, we ought to talk to Radzum in Grandal.
Meeting should be no problem. Teelan say he sent word to guard at Grandal ramparts to let friends through.
Before we visit this Radzum, I have something I wish to discuss with you all.
What is matter now?
The High Entia who live here now have lost all hope for the future. I have a duty. As the Imperial successor, I must safeguard their future. This will sound selfish, I know, but will you stand with me?
Of course I will, Melia.
Kino, too. And also Nene.
Thank you. It means a lot to me. Right. Off to Grandal we go.
Am I still missing something for this?
Miss Tyrea seemed like a difficult sort of person to deal with.
Difficult, huh? Maybe so, but she's still far more mellow than before.
Miss Melia and Miss Tyrea know each other from where?
Well, it's a little complicated to explain.
Complicated? How?
I'm just not quite sure where to begin. For one, Tyrea and I had never met until 1 year ago.
Houses too far apart, or...?
I was not allowed to venture outside. Moreover, I never even knew of her existence. She, on the other hand, seem to know about me. We never met because work had been busy.
But how Miss Melia never know her? If sisters, then of course she'd know.
That's true. How can I explain this? Tyrea and I have separate parents. Different fathers and different mothers, both.
Meme! In same boat as Nene and Kino, then!
Just like you and Kino, Tyrea and I are not related by blood. But we had a half-brother with whom we shared a parent each.
Half-brother?
Hmm. No parents in common, but a brother we are both related to. Therefore, Tyrea and I are not exactly complete strangers.
Me! Brain of Nene's starting to melt!
I'm sorry. I did say it's complicated.
Nene just not understand. If both have same brother, why cannot be one family together?
Our parents being different, I and Tyrea have led very different lives. We never even met, let alone behaved as a family. Neither knows how to relate to the other, and so we struggle on.
It sounds like Miss Melia and Miss Tyrea both feeling more like Kino.
How do you mean?
Kino also not talk to anyone at first. Very hidey-shy-shy.
I don't think I'd call myself or Tyrea shy, exactly.
If want to become good friends, but not know how to put in action, then it's exactly same. But, as can see for self, now Nene and Kino super best of friends.
Do tell, how did you two achieve that? Would you teach me the way, please?
Answer is clear as day. Nene prescribed lots of play-play.
Play-play?
Also, sharing of yummy snacks and sleep together in same bed. If do that, become family in wink of eye.
I'm not sure I can do that with Tyrea. Seems like a lot.
Meh! Nene patience is exhaust! Miss Melia want to be sisters with Miss Tyrea or not?
Yes. I would really like that, I think.
So, now is best and only chance. No time for hemmings and hawings.
Best and only? Hmm? Perhaps you're right.
Okay, then now Miss Melia go and say, "Hey, Sister Bon, come play."
Right now? I need some time to compose myself.
Oh, if Miss Melia must, but have to promise to ask soon.
Yes, I will. One day very soon.
Almost done. Let us keep up this blow.
Oh, I only have 2 coins. I thought that was a gill. I was like, man, they're just giving these away. Oops, I probably shouldn't have done that. Oh, well. Quest right here. I'm gonna make sure there's no more quests at the moment. Oh, I'll trigger that.
Greetings. We have heard from Teelan that a man called Radzim lives within these walls.
Ah, friends of Teelan's, are you? We've been expecting you. Go on, in you get.
You're letting us straight through.
You don't look particularly concerning, is all. These walls are imposing, but they aren't here for controlling foot traffic. They're to keep savage monsters from having themselves a rampage.
Most sensible. Well, we'll be going then.
Vikings! Sorry for time taking.
Why didn't you just let me through the little door you went through?
Thank you.
same shit. Ooh, a bunch of quests. Oh yeah, I was gonna call this an episode. So yeah, I think I will right here. Let me at least get to this. Okay, so thanks everyone for watching. My name is Sausage. Hope you're enjoying the playthrough, and please stay tuned for the next episode. Thanks everyone.